Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time to continue Eden Streak here in the Binding of Isaac Victa Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for supporting the like streak as well as the Eden Streak. Y'all have been going crazy ham on those like streak. The last two videos now, over 2,000 likes, even though that wasn't even the goal, man and woman. Thank you very much. 432 Eden wins in a row. C-Day is going to be 6 Kilo X-Ray Papa, 1 Charlie Whiskey Bravo. We've got terrible damage, bad tears, bad range, bad movement speed. Blind Rage. Also, we have the Potato Peeler and Guppy's Hairball. Now, Guppy's Hairball, of course, is not the best thing to start with, but it's not the worst. And I am encouraged by the fact that we at least have Potato Peeler, so if we do want to get rid of our bad damage, we can simply do so by merely just using our Spacebar to mill our Red Heart HP. Get Science or Common Cold, which is going to give us a Poison Tear effect every now and then. It's okay. It also coincidentally gives you the same look on Isaac's face as Ipecac, which is an item that I wish we had, as opposed to what we have right now. Yeah. So, yesterday's run, a lot of fun. Had a great time. Had a great time after everything started working out correctly. But before then, hoo doggy, I was concerned. I started going through the grieving process of this is probably going to be it. But then our salvation was delivered to us. If you haven't seen yesterday's run, I highly recommend it. If for anything, just to watch the last 2.5 minutes of the video. It was great. I saw somebody posted a comment yesterday saying that they didn't think the victory lap was going to happen because the video was nearly over. So, yeah. So that's the type of run you missed. But before then, if you happen to be a new subscriber, you did not see yesterday's run. Obviously, we won. But it's still worth watching because you need to go back and see just how bad it was. Now, we get bad starts, all right? That's just commonplace at this point for me and Eden. You can get some good starts, but mostly bad. And yesterday's did not feel... Like, today's start is worse than yesterday's start, arguably, just because of the lack of damage here. At least in yesterday's start, we had over 3 damage. But I think our tier delay was 17, so maybe not. It's just that the badness factor, like the bad factor of all the negatives that we had on yesterday's run, it's just that they lingered around so much more so than a normal run. Usually, if you have a really bad start, you can negate at least one of the many problems that you might have on a run like that within the first 3 or 4 floors at most. Usually, by most commonly, I would say that any early game problems that you're having are usually resolved, or at least partly resolved, via the first devil deal that you get. I think that's a pretty fair assessment to make. And it just, with yesterday's run, it was compounded by the fact that we not only weren't getting anything, on top of that, we weren't solving any of our issues either. Of course, we could get a HP upgrade here. I say unfortunately only because I wanted to get at least some sort of stat here. It is nice because obviously we can turn that into raw damage, but right now we need to... I can't do that yet because... I mean, I can, but I won't do that yet because we need to find out what we get out of our devil deal on the next floor. We don't know if we're going to be able to take an additional devil deal, especially if I use Potato Peeler right now. That drops us down to 2 red hearts, and yes, we would get the Cupid Meat or Ball of Bandages and also get... an associated damage upgrade, but we would lose one of our red heart containers, which is not exactly ideal if you're trying to take an early game devil deal. The luck upgrade there, so I'm happy about that. And Black freaking Candle, I really wish that we didn't use that bomb, man. There's not a soul art in here. I gotta go for broke. We're trying to make the big time plays here. We need a nickel and lots of money. That's nickel, but just barely enough money. I almost bought that tarot card and I would have allowed you to be mad at me. Okay. We have a little bit of room to breathe now. I still cannot use the potato peel. Oh, well. Okay, well, now I can't. Woo! Okay, all right. Hey, how you doing? All right. So yeah, we now have a damage upgrade, which you see our damage is still quite trash, but it's better than super trash, which is the name of my early 90s boy band. You didn't hear us. You didn't hear really anything from us. We were a little bit too underground indie for you. It's okay if you didn't. But obviously getting the cube meat gives us an alternative way to deal damage. Of course, it also adds to our defense, given the fact that we have used an orbital for blocking stuff, like projectiles and whatnot, and also we can use it to deal decent amounts of damage to stuff, as you see right there. Combined with Guppy's hairball, this means we have a very good chance of at least mitigating some guaranteed damage anytime that we may hit it, like sort of right there. Anytime we were sort of almost hit by it, I should say. Tigerim's going to be down here almost all the time. Normally, I would use a bomb to get that keeper, but right now, I'm not going to do that. There's this tinted rock here, which I do want. A very odd place for the item room here. Happy to have small rock, of course, and we get super bandage. Okay. Only reason why I'm sort of scoffing at that is because, again, we don't need HP anymore. We get fistula. Oh, but everyone, you'll enjoy this. We don't actually get a devil deal because the game decided that we don't want one. I'm saying, what are you talking about, Victor? If you notice that our devil deal chance is at zero, that's because we are in a room that cannot possibly spawn a devil item, a devil door. So, yeah. Now, some people are going to say that rarely happens, but for me, I'm pretty sure that's happened at least 10 times on the streak so far. Probably actually way more than that. And it's really annoying. It's one of the few times that you'll get genuine, like, frustration out of a player, because there's literally nothing that you can do about that. That is, in every sense of the word, literally the game just screwing you over. And you can't do a damn thing about it either. Unless if you have a Joker card, or if you get Goathead somehow. But even then, the game will temporarily spawn that devil deal, but it won't be attached to the boss room. I don't think it will anyway. But this just happens to have a room generation where it is impossible for the game to generate a devil door. So they just don't give one to you. It doesn't matter if it's the second floor or not. It's just the game, like I said, giving you the middle finger.
Heard you want a devil deal, 4-2. Oh, sorry, loser. Room's too small. Try again, nerd.
So we make our way to the third floor with a guaranteed devil deal, hopefully. Unless if it's Curse the XL, then that would be even worse. I don't know what I'm bombing for. It's not like we have enough money. Ooh, Joker card, 2 of diamonds. All right. Okie dokie. Now the real question is, how much of our HP are we going to use to get damage? With a level 2 cube of meat, we have level 2 meat boy now as an orbital, so he deals damage by way of, well, contact damage, because obviously he's an orbital, and secondly, of course, he also fires out little shots here and there. Might as well do the rest of it. This is a very, very big floor two. Always go for the leftmost Mullaboom in here first. I was kind of hoping that Mullaboom was going to, was possibly going to open a crawl space there. Now we could get a level 4 Meat Boy and go down to 1 HP. That's going pretty ham. But essentially, I'm not going to do that yet for the exact same reason why I didn't do it on the last floor, which is that, we need to get a devil deal first. Super secret room cannot be here. Cannot be here. Cannot be there. Okay, we did not get Curse the XL. I'm not going to thank the game for that because we shouldn't. I'm an idiot. What am I talking about? We got Black Candle. It's been a long day today. A long day of trying to rest my voice. We had another band meeting today for the next song, which I'm very excited about. The next song is looking to be very, very metal. I had a great great week of streaming. on Twitch. Thank you for those of you who came by to say hello, and those of you who actually joined the Twitch Mosh Pit as well, by way of Twitch Prime subs. It was a pleasure having everyone, and it's nice seeing the both sides of the Mosh Pit intermingle. Almost like a mosh pit. I'm debating doing that mob trap room because, again, we do have this Two of Diamonds, so obviously that would... It would benefit us greatly if we were able to get a lot of money out of that golden chest, but at the same time, we could also get nothing. So, I don't think that there's really much to do other than just wait. Let's go straight to the boss room. Let's see what we can get out of our devil deal, if we can get one. I mean, I know that we're going to get one, obviously. It's, you know, we shouldn't lose any of our soul hearts. I'm just saying, if there's a devil deal, like if it's not a no item devil deal. Or a Krampus fight. I wish there was a trinket that made it to where you don't get Krampus. Or like if somehow you had Lump of Coal already without, like if you got it through the mystery gift. If you already possess Lump of Coal, you cannot get Krampus inside of a devil deal. I think that'd be neat. But Lump of Coal already does a lot of things, so they may think that's a little bit too many things. That's our item room and our shop are right next to each other, which means that the boss room is going to be south of here. I really don't think doing the mob trap room is going to be worth it. 8-inch nails, however, is absolutely worth it. It's going to be a full damage and a half upgrade. We get another Two of Diamonds. Okay, so this could be big here. We do not want to reroll Hive Mind. We want to get a nickel here, which we did. We can double this to go to 9 cents. We can double this to go to 18 cents and then double it again for 36 cents. I'm going to hold off on that until we find more money. But we are absolutely going to be taking Hive Mind here. With us starting with a Guppy item, I'm being hopeful that we get another Guppy item inside of this Devil Deal. Now, with the presence of these two Two of Diamonds cards, though, it is worth it for us to now go into the mob trap room and see what's inside that golden chest. A Yara rune would be huge here. Can't tell if that's a Yara rune or not yet. It is a Degas rune. Is decidedly a lot less huge. Alges will hold on to two Alges runes. Okay, this could be a Yara rune though for the blank rune. Okie dokie. We're gonna take the Alges. Well, first off, we're gonna take the Alges rune just to go use it against the boss. It's a guaranteed free kill. We'll go back and go get our Two of Diamonds. And then we'll go do the mob trap room. No damage up from matchbook. We'll get a couple of bombs here. Not that big of a deal. We'll get Judas's freaking shadow. Not only does that allow us to get to turn into Black Judas, it also allows us to get out of the mob trap room. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to use Potato Peeler. We're going to take Judas's shadow. We're also going to take the Two of Diamonds here and not walk inside of the hatch. Okay, so why use the Potato Peeler? Obviously, I want to convert our HP. We're not going to stay as Isaac. We're going to turn... I mean, we're always Isaac, but you know what I mean. We're going to turn into Black Judas here. And it just gives us... It gives us a nice little value out of our old Red Hearts that we no longer need because we're about to turn into the most powerful character in the game. And what's even better about this is that we're able to get out of the mob trap room for free because we can just simply kill ourselves in there and then resurrect outside the doors as Black Judas and everything's honky-dory. Unless I bung it up and die here, which I need to just go do this now before I end up like dying to something stupid and ruining the entire plan. That's definitely something that could happen. Okay, so we got a little bit of extra money. That's great. Again, seeing that soul heart there is even better. Oh yeah, we had the virus. I forgot we had the virus. So we are now Black Judas, and as you see there, our damage went sky high. So with 11 cents, we can now turn that into 44 cents thanks to the two of diamonds. It's still worth it for us to go look for more money And we really need to change Isaac's face because, good God. Full charges. It'd be nice if we had blank card. I just want my regular Black Judas. Yeah, there you go. He's got a bow in his hair. He's also got a band-aid on. He had a little bit of a boo-boo. That's okay. You still love him anyway. Okay, so let's use the Two of Diamonds now. We're going to cash this in. Two of Diamonds. And we'll take one of the extra Algis runes here. I am going to take the Hive Mind. I was going to take the blue map, because why not? Might as well see what this is. Magician card. Pretty useless. And we don't need the key. I was kind of hoping that it was going to be a Hangman card so we can get that Black Soul Heart, but that's okay. Well, head on down. What a nice turnaround that was. Good floor. We got a quality tier upgrade. We got a future-proof upgrade in Hive Mind. We turn into Black Judas, of course, which is a huge damage up. Basically an all stats up at that point. And we gave ourselves damage by way of the Potato Peeler by shedding our Red Hearts. We also got a level 4 Meat Boy, which is great, while maintaining a level 1 Orbital. So things are looking really, really strong in this run early on. Again, a far cry from what we had yesterday. I'm actually going to hold on to Blind Rage because I don't like the Burnt Penny, only because it has a very high tendency to spawn Troll Bombs on you whenever you pick up coins. There we go. Okie dokie, and we got nothing. All right, I could use the Algis rune there, but that's a pretty big waste for 3 cents and one key, which is my favorite Beck song, by the way. So I'm now Isaac. Go. I got 3 cents and a key. And all it cost me was an Algis Ray. It doesn't work at all. We could go for Mr. Boom here, but I would much rather have the ability to shed Red Hearts that I don't want. I've never listened to Beck. I know Loser and Where It's At. That's it. Most people say, you mean two turntables and a microphone? It's actually called Where It's At. As someone who is a Beck aficionado, I know all of 2 songs by him. I can tell you that most people say, two turntables and a microphone. I have to put on my actually glasses. Okay. Normally I would say the secret room's to the left of here, but given the fact that we have the blue map, we know it's not there. Loving our shot speed and our range. Our range could go a little bit better, but our shot speed's great. We could look for Magic Mush if I really wanted to inside of the mushrooms, but fast bombs. Oh, we use bombs here. There we go. I mean, I know I'm lazy, and I'm trying to get better about it, even though we truly don't need Magic Mush, as dumb as that may sound. Death Guard. The Soul Heart. We don't need Buddy in a Box. We also don't need King Baby. We'll just go ahead and wait. Of course, I took the left hand. The left hand is going to turn all chests that we see into dark chests or red chests or cursed chests, whatever you want to call them. And that's significant because it does one of 2 things. First off, it gives us a much higher chance to get a Devil Deal because we can spawn chests that can give us a portal to the Devil Deal. Secondly, it also gives us a good foundation for possibly getting a lot of Soul Hearts for the rest of the run, since they have a very high tendency to spawn inside of cursed chests. And thirdly, we also give ourselves the ability to get Guppy by way of either finding it into the chest or because of the fact that we're going into Devil Deals. But now that we have Goat Head here, that's neither here nor there. We got the Spun transformation thanks to Roid Rage, and we are looking pretty darn good. I wouldn't say looking good. We're looking kind of weird, Isaac. But this run is looking very good. Depression, don't really need it. It's not really worth going through the hassle of doing the Mob Trap Room. Couldn't believe it though. When I was looking at the we had 2600 likes on Friday's episode. Then Saturday's episode, the day that I'm recording this, there's 2900 likes on that episode. That's crazy, man.
You didn't use your Algis runes, Invicta. Roar!
We didn't need it. We did not need it. If anything, you could argue that I should be using my Algis rune for any blood banks that we find to get red hearts so I can give myself even more damage, or we can use it for just getting, you know, money for whatever we need it for. And you see here, look at that, double soul heart payout after another double soul heart payout. I'll take it. Looking for another guppy item. Another double soul heart payout. Left hand. You all right. Get our bomb back and another soul heart. I mean, our luck is 1.79, which isn't that high, but, and I don't know if luck actually dictates how well your fortune is for getting soul hearts out of red chests, but all I can say is that so far, so good. Level 4 Meat Boy doing a good job here. BFF would be an amazing upgrade for us. Of course, we're still looking for Guppy. We're hopeful. We're hopeful for Guppy. I would say that our odds of getting Guppy are extremely high because of two reasons. One, we have guaranteed double deals from here on out. I'll take Eden's Blessing for the tears up. Most of the time, I would skip it though, because I don't want to deal with the extra item on the next run, but I'm not going to get into that controversy. So this is Depths 1. We would only get literally one use out of more options, so I don't think it's worth it. Ominous Key, however, is definitely worth it. Starter deck I would take. That would allow me to hold on to this Algis rune, but also possibly get like an extra Joker card or something. We'd go get a double deal in the Cathedral, since one won't spawn naturally. We need 5 more cents. We should be able to do that. Eden's Blessing, by the way, gives you a tears up, which can break the tears cap, but more importantly, it will give you an extra item on your next run. Period. It doesn't mean you have to be Eden. It doesn't matter who you're playing. The next time that we boot up, we will have an extra item. Okay, so that's our ticket. This is our ticket right here to starter deck. I didn't want to have to use my Algis rune for this, but I don't think we're going to need the Algis rune really for anything. We certainly don't need it for survival right now, especially given how much damage we have, and we're Black Judas, and we have a level 4 Cuban meat. I'm pretty sure that doing damage is going to be our specialty here, and not having to play defensive. Okay, that's good enough. Solid amount of money there. Let's go back and pick up starter deck. We have plenty of bombs, so we can re-roll for something else as well. Got a magician card, and we also got a chariot card. And there's blank card, which I will take. If we can just get an emperor card, then we are golden. Magician card. Chariot card. So, blank card chariot is not bad at all. Again, given the fact that we do... Oh, hey, a snipper card. Oh, never mind then. I will take the free win. Thank you, game. Thank you. And selfishly, I apologize in advance, but my voice is still recovering, so I am going to take the... I'm going to take the route that I wanted to take yesterday, but couldn't. And we'll go for a quick end here to this run. I'm still gonna go, like, you know, try to get Guppy and stuff, but to show you why Blank Card Emperor is so nice to have, because you can just skip straight to the bosses. I think after yesterday's run, plus, I mean, hey, look, I did an extra victory lap and we didn't really have to, so I'm gonna count that as a win. Been loving Epic 7 again. We do have a Mosh Pit guild set up on Epic 7 on global server. I saved up some, for those of you who don't play that game, by the way, just ignore the next 30 seconds. I saved up some bookmarks, did some summons. I was able to get a Destina for memory imprint. And I also got a Syria, which is a new Nat 5 for me. So I felt good about that. And then my ML summons, my Moonlight summons came out, and they did not go, let's just say they did not go as planned. I'm doing the mob trap room over here just because I'm trying to get a full charge on our blank card so we can go straight to the Emperor. And this is just the benefit of having blank card Emperor. If you know for a fact that you're just set for a run, then feel free to do this. I'm doing this so I can continue to rest my voice. We got our second Guppy item here. Almost a third Guppy item, almost. I will take Eye of Belial because with piercing shots with our damage, that's going to be tons and tons of damage. On top of our already great damage. After the headache that was yesterday's run, I will graciously accept a give me run here. It would be nice to get Guppy if it happens, but if not, game, you know what? That's okay. We don't have the Polaroid, so it doesn't matter if we got Polaroid invincibility or not. Now, even though our damage is quite good, it's not kill hush in 5 seconds good. Unless if I had a specific reason to go to Hush's store, I'm not gonna go fight Hush. Head on down. We'll go talk to Stanley. Yeah. Again, with the fact that we don't have the polar, we have the negative. It doesn't matter what our HP is at. The negative will always trigger on hit. If we had, it basically does an Necronomicon effect if you don't have any HP, any red heart HP. So instead of giving you a Polaroid invincibility shield like the Polaroid does, instead it will just simply do the Necronomicon effect whenever you take damage when you have less than or equal to 1/2 heart. You know what? I think we can find a much easier room to do. You're seeing the awesome power of piercing shots here against the knights. There we go. I got my timing back on the bombs at least. I'm gonna be slightly sad if we don't get Guppy. Lots of damage there done by level 4 Meat Boy as well. Absolute domination, and I am happy to have it. So thank you, everybody, again, weathering the bad runs and the negativity. I really appreciate it. Darkabumu. I'll get rid of our red art. I mean, it's Darkbum. And we did not get Guppy. Hey, look, Sinvicta's going to finally remember that we have Black Candle. Look, we took Cursed Eye. Aren't you proud of me, gang? Aren't you proud of me? Now we don't have to worry about the teleportation effect anymore. If you don't know what I'm talking about, by the way, I'm being kind of a smart aleck. Because I always forget. Because, like, Cursed Eye is always such an automatic no pickup for me under any circumstance unless I have marked. that I always forget that when we have Black Candle, it does cancel out the worst part about Cursed Eye. Other than the fact that Cursed Eye shows up way off, way, like, often, more often than it should. So, I'm gonna go drink some nice warm honey tea. Rest my voice. Thank you all very much, sincerely, for all the likes this past weekend. Thank you for those of you who came out to the Twitch TV Mosh Pit as well. I really do appreciate that. I really do. 433 wins in the book. Who's gonna stop us? Not nobody. You know why? Well, it's because we're adequately okay at this game. Yeah.